Hey, welcome to Turbulent. If you're looking at this video, you probably want to develop a micro hydropower plant. In this video series, we're gonna show you the tricks and tools that we use to find potential sites. So, let's jump right into it. You want to develop a vortex turbine. That means that you need certain characteristics for your site to actually be able to generate energy. One of the things that you will need is a certain minimum height difference. That means the difference in height between the upper water level and the lower water level. Basically, the height that the water is falling down. And then next, we also need a certain flow. And that flow should be big enough to actually generate some power. Now, how you're gonna be measuring these things, I will show you in the next video. But right now, it's enough to know how to eyeball a site and know if it will actually work for you. Yeah, there are two options when you want to develop this kind of a site. Either you already have a site in mind and you just want to develop it with a vortex turbine, or you know you want to install a vortex turbine, but you don't really have an idea yet of where you can install it. We get this question a lot. We have customers like NGOs who want to electrify a village. We have customers like businesses who want to lower their costs, or private people who just want to live self-sufficiently. I'm going to show you now which kind of tools and resources we use to find sites. When you're looking for sites, preferably start looking in hilly terrain, just light, gently hilly terrain, with, of course, water. Deserts, sorry, you can't help. In these areas, you can then look for either just natural rivers or more man-made structures. When you're looking at rivers, you kind of want to find places where you have white water or where there's some bubbling going on, you know? That normally indicates that there's enough inclination there to install a vortex turbine. What you can also look for is, okay, we have this river here with like a nice curvy river, and then on Google Maps you start to look for, okay, I have this river and I'm gonna find the inclination between point A and point B. And if that inclination is more than 2%, then you have a very good chance of installing a vortex turbine there. Except for natural rivers, you can also look for man-made structures. For instance, another kind of ideal site for us is like an old water mill. And you have a lot of those. And you also have in every country, you have databases of where you can find these old water mills. Either that they don't exist anymore or that they're like in disrepair and in urgent need of a turbine. The next kind of man-made structure you can look into are weirs or small unpowered dams. These are basically just waiting for a turbine. They're ideal for what we offer. And this can be a weir, like so, or an unpowered dam. It can be a sluice gate. It can be any kind of thing that basically creates that little height difference between upper water level and lower water level. Another man-made structure that we all know are irrigation canals. Now, some places are really full of these things. And if you have hilly terrain, then they will always have canal falls. And these falls are ideal for a vortex turbine. Basically, what you can then do is find one site in an irrigation canal, and before you know it, you will probably find 5-10 more. So what you can then do is you cascade the turbines along that canal, and you can produce suddenly like maybe a megawatt of clean energy where previously there was nothing possible. So now you should have a few sites in mind. And in the next video, we'll show you how to go out there and measure the sites and see if they can be used for a vortex turbine. If you already want to see that video, you can click the link here. And for the rest, thank you for watching. If you want more updates of us, don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.